Hello, my name is Sanchita Islam and I'm an artist and I'm a writer as well. And I write lots of poems, hundreds of poems. I've published a volume of poems called The Eternal Pollution of a Dented Mind. That was a while ago now. So since then I've written hundreds of poems and they're just gathering dust on my hard drive, becoming a form of mental junk. And I don't know why I write them. They just land in my head like bullets and then they explode, and there's a compulsion to put them down on paper, and so that's what I do. But now there's so many of them, it's becoming a bit ridiculous. But writing is as mandatory as a bodily function. I see this as a form of mental excrement, and you know, I have to get it out before more mental excrement builds up in my head. It's a form of cleansing in a way, and it's bewildering. But you know, often I'm in the pit and sitting in my own, I'm sorry to be scatological, but yeah, you're sitting in your own mental shit and you're sort of playing around with it and thinking, how do I get out of this pit? And if you can turn the darkness into gold, then I think it's worth inhabiting the darkness. If you can do something productive with it, it's when it becomes all consuming and sapping that it can be destructive. And yeah, so I always think sharing is a good thing to do and trying to help people, being altruistic. And as an artist, you spend hours and hours on your own, and it can be unhealthy. And I was ambivalent about social media for so long. I only started with it at the beginning of this year, mainly to promote my book, Schizophrenics Can Be Good Mothers Too, which I wrote under a pseudonym. Well, that's sort of blown that one out of the water. But anyway, but now I see social media as a tool to campaign about mental health and to make the world a little bit more tolerant for my children. Because the condition that I have, schizoaffective disorder, I think it's partly inherited, that there's a gene, a mad gene, on my maternal and paternal side. So I feel a little bit like I'm not culpable. It's not my fault that my brain is like this. And I don't think it's something that I should be ashamed about, because, you know, I'm coherent, I'm functioning, I'm working, I'm, you know, earning and doing my art and my writing. So why should I carry this label? I don't want it. You can take it back. I even refuse to use certain language that is touted around to describe people with different sorts of brains. Anyway, I've gone off on a tangent. The poem that I'm going to read is To Live on the Moon, Gazing Up at the Stars. And it's about a collision that I had with two monkeys. And it's also based on an email that I wrote to Stephen Fry, who's been a friend of mine since 2008. I share my work with him and my poems and my art, and he responds, and he's been a big support. So, yeah, okay. A kind word is sometimes all you need to get out of the pit that seems darker and deeper than ever, egging me on to jump, to cut, to carve a clumsy end, to hang from the straps of my Gucci shoes, to lay and wait to be discovered by innocent little faces. To hell with all that morbid nonsense. Knew it would pass eventually if I stuck it out, but 2 months it lasted, this interminable wretched blackness. I thought I was going to die, and then today, even though there is no sun in the sky, or a slice of blue to cling onto, the weather finally changed. The sun came out in my head, and when it does, I am dancing and singing and shouting at the heavens, screaming, "I'm still alive, you fucking bastards." But never mind all of that. What matters are those spontaneous moments of joy that are all there for the taking. As I cycled with the little one, trying hard to breathe, a tree began to shake and shed a copious tumble of golden leaves. Looked up, and there they were. Two monkeys dancing in the trees with coal eyes and black skinny fingers to match. "Mr. Monkey, how are you today?" I asked and shook his hand. Before he bit it and scampered off, it was a tantalizing marvel to see those teeth marks in my flesh. And finally, I could feel again as the blood poured. Slowly, the morbid lows dissipate into the polluted air. It was delirious to be high and garrulous and excited again. Time is so precious, vital to free up as much as you can, so you can stuff the days with slices of wonder, gorge on it all, and then burp gloriously. All going to sleep happy, warm, snug, and loved, if you're lucky to be loved. I'm not alone. There are allies in the universe that seems barren, empty, and full of pits designed to fall into. But from that pit, I rise, soaring up onto a cloud, to live on the moon, gazing up at the stars. So that's poem number one, and more to follow, and I hope you enjoyed that.